summer of 2008, LAPD created the Skid Row History Museum at the Box Gallery. It included a number of art objects that had originally been made and used as protest objects. It also had a room-sized map that showed the shrinking of the neighborhood due to gentrification, and a long timeline and a whole room of archival materials documenting the grassroots development of Skid Row from the 30s till now. During the month, we had many performances by LAPD and other Skid Row artists. And the gallery show and related activities contributed to the planning of our public art project to commemorate Skid Row's artistic and social visionaries.
I remember the Downtown Women's Center opened. It was right there where the Midnight Mission is.
1978.
Yep.
Like, it would end up like this woman was part of the Downtown Women's Center, so that would end up like outside the Women's Center.
Y'all know where recovery happened?
Right here!
Right out here in these mean streets.
Yeah, right here.
See, Red was my recovery specialist, was my treatment counselor when I was in treatment at the VOA. Red has been sober for over 10 years. Now, before he got sober, Red lived in a box on 6th and Crocker for decades. He used to point it out to us as we would be going from one meeting to another meeting. And he's gonna do a monologue for you.
This is called the Town Street Incident. It's a fictive narrative by Ricky C. Medley, based on action by David Bush.
Yeah, you're right. Right on time, Tony.
I just got out of jail last Friday. I was arrested last Wednesday morning, 2/28/07, at 6th and Town Street, at about 9:30 a.m., for refusing to take down an empty tent with a sign on it that said, "The Safer Cities Initiative is racist policing."
Who knows Officer Ridge in this?
Department of Public Social Service, and he's been the guard there. People's lives are saved. People don't go to jail because of Officer Rich. He's one of the first people I want to put up there, and it's just, it breaks my heart that he's a cop.
I started working with the folks we call homeless in 1975 in Santa Monica and Venice. I was associated with OPCC, as it's called now, it was called Ocean Park Community Center, for 10 years. And we started working with folks who were, we call them transients and hippies and other names, mostly living on the beach folks. But you know, a phenomenon was happening back then, which was a whole lot of folks were coming out of the mental institutions with basically no help out there. They were just sort of let go and told, go and get on meds and go and get on SSI. You can do all of that now, just go and do that.
I came to Los Angeles last week of September of 1985. The very next week, John Malpeed started two performance workshops. He was giving up rooms at NC Law, at that time it was located at 524 South San Pedro, and the other one was at the mayor in the 600 block of San Diego.
The time is running out. You've got to hit the road, Jack, because it's inventory time. 10987, Jack, 654321, Jack. Pick up, Jack.
When Safer Cities started 2 years ago, Al was spends time up in Pershing Square. So the police and private security started really cracking down on Pershing Square, moving folks out, taking folks' property, telling folks they couldn't be there in a public park. And so Al just took it upon himself. He was like, we need to do something about Pershing Square as part of our anti-SCI, and he got excited or whatever. One day he comes in, and this was my turning point for Al. This was before people named him the White Doga, long before. He comes in one day and he's like, you know what? Back in the day, I used to really wonder why those Black Panthers and militants were so mad. Now I know why they were so damn mad.
Where they be taken and the trees